as far as the darkness is concerned. So as far as the deep sleep is concerned, says manabhavaha svapaha. And so manabhavaha, when there is no pramana prameya vyavahara, meaning the deep sleep state, which is called tamaha, anvaya aprameyatva. So tamonvaya aprameyatva tadabhavepi nekshare. In tamaha, in the darkness, in the deep sleep, there is no knowledge at all of any kind, and therefore the non-duality, the knowledge of non-duality. Non-duality is never covered by anything, by the way. Ajnanena vrtam jnanam tena mukhyanti jantavaha. That the knowledge is covered by ignorance, meaning knowledge of non-duality is covered by ignorance, never non-duality. Self can never be covered, it is ever shining, self-revealing, and therefore nobody can ever close, switch off that bulb. We can switch off this bulb, but we can never switch off the bulb that is our own self. Even in the deep sleep state also, that bulb ever shines in its own glory. Nobody can switch that off. But the knowledge of the non-dual self can definitely be covered by the blanket of ignorance. That's what happens in the deep sleep state. Of course, in the waking and dream also. In the deep sleep, waking and dream, all along, the knowledge of non-dual self is covered by ignorance. And furthermore, in the waking and dream state, the superimpositions are created of the karta abhokta, where in fact there is akarta abhokta atma. In the deep sleep state, that kind of pramana prameya vyavahara involving the karta abhokta is not there, but then the knowledge is nevertheless covered by the blanket of ignorance, and therefore tadabhavah. Tadabhavepi na ikshate. So tatravi na taddhihi ajnana pratibandhat tanmeyatva asiddhihi. So aprameyatva. Therefore, tamonvaya aprameyatva. There is no prameyatvam again, advidyatma cannot be known in the deep sleep state also. Ajnana pratibandhat, because there is pratibandha. In waking and dream there are two pratibandhas, ajnana and tatkarya. In waking and dream state, the knowledge of the self is covered by ignorance as well as the misapprehension created by ignorance. In the deep sleep state, the knowledge is covered by ignorance. So, this much is the difference between three. So this is the problem. When you say that, may you know the self as Atma, how can you know? That's the question. How can you ever know? Then further, see the tika. Mahabhut Atmadehi Sadhu Swayameva Swajnana Ajnana Tajje Nivartaishyate Bodhatmatvat Tasmat Apratibandhat Tasmin Pramabhi Sada Syadvyashankya. Somebody says, Mahabhut Atmadehi. Alright. Atmadehi Mahabhut. Let there be no knowledge of Atma. Okay. Sadhu Swayameva Swajnana Tajje Nivartaishyate Bodhatmatvat. Bodhatmatvat. Saha Atma Bodhatmatvat. Since Atma himself is of the nature of Bodha or the knowledge, there is no need to know the Atma. Atma itself, himself will dispel. Ajnana and Tajje means Tatkaryam. So we would say that the self being of the nature of knowledge and self-effulgence, there is no need to know the self, because the self being self-evident will dispel the ignorance and the misapprehension born of ignorance. So why do you have to have the knowledge of yourself? Self itself is capable of dispelling that ignorance and all the misapprehensions, because bodhatmatvat, because self or atma is of the nature of bodha or knowledge. So this problem always arises in different ways. If you say that atma is of the nature of knowledge, how can there be ignorance of atma? And who is ignorant? Atma is ignorant. So ultimately we have to arrive at these conclusions. Who is ignorant? Atma is ignorant. Which Atma? Satchidananda Vijnanadhana Atma is ignorant. Ignorant of what? Ignorant of his own self. So how can Atma, who is of the nature of knowledge, be ignorant? And how can there be ignorance of the Atma, who is self-shining and self-revealing? That only shows that Atma is unopposed to ignorance. But that kind of a question is asked in different ways here. That why don't we say that there is no need for knowledge of Atma, because according to you, Atma is self-evident and of the nature of awareness. And therefore, bodhātmatvāt, since Atma is of the nature of bodha or the knowledge, therefore we say that svajñāna tajje nivartaiṣyati, that Atma will be able to dispel the ignorance and all the misapprehensions born of it. It will tell you. Why do you worry about it? Because it is self-evident. Tasmat apratibandhat tasmin pramāpi sadāsyāt. Therefore the kind of pratibandha or the obstacles that you are talking about in knowledge of Atma will not be there, because Atma itself will eliminate this pratibandhas, because it is the nature of knowledge. Tasmin pramāpi sadāsyāt. And therefore there must be all the time prama or knowledge of Atma also. Iti āśaṅkya, this is the āśaṅkā. But so when we look at the nature of Atma, we just cannot understand, or it doesn't make sense as to how there can be ignorance pertaining to Atma, who is self-effulgent and of the nature of knowledge. Whether it makes sense or not, it is a matter of experience. This is how Vedantins go. And then create sense out of it. The thing is that the fact is there is samsara. If you say then Atma cannot be samsari at all, because Atma is nitya shuddha buddha mukta svabhava sva prakasha svada siddha, self-effulgent, self-evident, self-existing, never complete, unaffected, asangaha. And therefore there can be no samsara at all. And that's the question. Samsara anavatarasyat manavaifulyamevacha. Where are we now? Continuing the tika. Iti āśaṅkya sāmānya nyāyamaha nahi iti. Where are we? Nahi. I should read the other word. Nahi vastva atma nahi va atma moha yuchitta ye kvatida. Yeah. Nahi vastva atma vastvātmana eva atma moha di uchitta ye kvatida pramāna nirapekṣam sad vastu alam sva prasiddhaye. Vastu, vastvātmana eva, mohādi ucchitte, pramāna nirapeksham, nahi kvachit alam. So that's how the verse is, the anvaya there. Or, see the tika, shuktyādi vastu svarupena eva, pramāna anapeksham sata, su avidyā tajya anupanuttaye, svagnyaptaye va na kvachit abideshādu shaktam drishtam. So take the example, the standard example of Shuktyadi, Shukti, Rajata, or the rope and snake. So where in fact there is rope, which is all the time seen by you, and still there is a superimposition of snake there. So just because the rope is rope, does not mean that it will reveal itself as a rope. The rope is known as a rope only when there is pramanam. Only when the rope is revealed by a competent means of knowledge. What happens is, in order to know, see any object, you require not only eyes, but you also require the aloka or the prakasha to reveal that object. So this book can be perceived by a being. Not because I have only eyes in the book, but the book also should be illumined. Then alone the eyes can perceive the book. What happens in case of the rope is that eyes are there, rope also is there. But that aloka, that light which is required to illumine the rope, is not there in sufficient measure, and therefore there arises this misapprehension. Every day it arises in Ahmedabad. Every evening you drive, or you ride, I don't drive, just riding this car, I just wonder how this whole vyavahara goes on, you know. Because you cannot see anything on the road. And with the kind of eyes I have, you can't, you see the things that are not there. That's what happens to me. So in fact, the so-called street lights, they seem to create more darkness than light. Or whatever light is there, some funny effect is created. So I always am surprised, all of a sudden I find a cyclist going this way, a pedestrian running that way, which I never saw. So I find myself being surprised, you know. And these fellows are confident in driving, and driving with speed. So how does this happen? I don't know, but in fact, when the light is not sufficient, it creates more problems. If there is no light at all, that flood light of the car will be sufficient to illumine the object properly.
But with these street lights and things that are there, these flood lights and those street lights combine to create some new objects which are not there anyway. So when the light is not there in sufficient measure, then misapprehension is created. Similarly also, in case of the rope snake example, since there is not enough light, it creates this snake which is not there. Every evening I have this experience, and particularly when it is raining, and the funny combination of the street light and the headlights are there. Headlights being what they are, you know, they themselves are highly insufficient, and these street lights, everything is insufficient, and people are plenty, and all cyclists without their lights, and all these even scooters also. I don't know why these people don't switch on their headlights, and people don't switch on their wipers. I don't know. They think that by running wipers, they will some power, you know, some more power will be lost. But they do not know that when the engine is running, the battery is constantly being charged. And when the battery is charged, the rest of that power goes waste anyway. I don't know why people have these problems here, you know. That if you switch on the headlight, then also, but then the battery is all, that's made the purpose of battery, which is being charged by the engine anyway, you know. A moment there comes a traffic light, they switch on the engine, that's all. They don't realize that in turning on the engine, lot of power is wasted. In fact, that switching off and on is a very inefficient process as far as running the engine is concerned, and more petrol is wasted by switching on that engine than the petrol would have been wasted had it been idling the engine. But anyway, this is that has nothing to do with this. What I am saying is that how all kinds of misapprehensions are created when sufficient light is not there. That's all the problem is. The rope is there. What I am perceiving is rope, but because of lack of sufficient light, that mandandhakara has some effect that it creates what is not there. It creates snake which is not there. And therefore, the rope is lying there. In spite of its being rope, there is nothing that the rope can do with reference to the delusion of the snake that is there in our mind. The only way that the rope can be known is when pramana, meaning proper lighting condition, is established. Therefore, when you show a torch light there, proper lighting condition is established, and then one sees a rope as rope. When improper lighting conditions were there, that's in our life also. If Atma is totally unknown, there will be no problem at all. If the broad daylight is there, no problem with the rope, I see it as rope. Total darkness is there, again there is no problem, I won't see it at all. So in total darkness and total light, there is no problem because there is no occasion for misapprehension. Misapprehension is in that funny situation of mandanda, twilight situation. But anyway, similarly, constantly what I am perceiving is my own self, but because of a twilight situation, I see it and still don't see it. That's how the misapprehensions are created. So, shuktyadi vastu swarupenaiva. Just because shuktika, the mother of pearl, is there, or the rope is there, and that is this rope or mother of pearl, it is not able to reveal itself as what it is. Pramana nirapeksham sada. Without pramana, meaning without the proper lighting condition, so whatever defect is there, unless the defect is removed in pramana, that object cannot be known as it is. So avidya tajya apanuttaye swagnyaptayeva nakvachitvishayadeshadurukshaktam drashtam. And how that shuktika or the rope is not capable of dispelling its own ignorance or all the misapprehension. The rope doesn't say, wait a minute, I am not a rope. I am not a snake, don't worry. So I look at the rope and I am scared. The rope sees me being scared. Doesn't declare, wait a minute, I am not a snake, don't worry. Doesn't say that. So when would I come to know that it is not a snake? Only when enough light is shown there. Then alone the rope becomes capable of revealing itself when pramana is there. Without pramana or a valid means of knowledge, the rope is not known, nor the misapprehensions created by the ignorance of rope are also not eliminated. This is called samanya nyaya. This is the samanya means this is a general thing that is known, general rule that is known to us in our day-to-day life. That's samanya. So the verse said, Nahi vastvatmana eva, just because vastu is vastu. Atma mohadi uchchite na kvachit alam, pramana nirapeksham. Just because vastu is vastu, does not mean that it can remove its ignorance. Oh, the whole world is there. But then we are all ignorant. We did not know there was such a thing as law of gravity. We did not know there is such a thing called, what is it? The relativity. Or that there is an absolute reality we never knew. We always took the reality as relative and so forth. So things are there. Satya is always there. But just because Satya is there does not mean that it will be known. It can be known only when pramanam or the valid means of knowledge. Otherwise science is not required. Nothing is required. You don't require science at all, but what is science? Is inquiry with the help of adequate and proper means of knowledge. And therefore, general rule is that the vastu is not known unless there is pramana vyavahara there. Nor does it reveal itself, so prasiddhe. So says Tika, kintu pramanam apekshayeva yathokta karyaya paryaptam ityartha. Kintu pramana apekshayeva. Only with the need, with the help of pramanam or valid means of knowledge, that any vastu is able to be known, and all misapprehensions about that vastu are also eliminated. Yathokta karyaya paryaptam. Yathokta karya means for knowledge of that vastu and for dispelling all the misapprehensions about it. Now continuing the tika. Suktyadu jade mana pekshamapi atmani swaprakashi tadapeksham vina swarupa bodhat abodhadi dvastihi dhyasin kyaha. Okay. So you are giving example always of rajata and shuktika, you know, and rope and snake. So you give the example of rope, snake, and make point about atma. This is unfair, it is, you know, because the rope or the shuktika are not comparable to atma. Shuktyadu jade man apekshayam. Okay, shukti meaning that mother of pearl or the rope or all these objects of the world, such as law of gravity and whatever they are, all of them are jada, all of them are inert. An inert thing cannot reveal itself in ever man apeksha. There is need for pramanam with reference to knowing the jada vastu. Atma is swaprakashe tadapeksham vina. But atma is not jada. Atma is swaprakashe, self-effulgent. And so tadapeksham vina, mana apeksham vina, swarupa bodha. Therefore, you don't require pramanam to reveal the atma who is self-effulgent. And therefore, abodhadi dvastihi. Therefore, we would expect that dvasti meaning there will be dispelling of ignorance and all misapprehension because atma is self-effulgent. So no pramanam should be required for revealing atma. Iti asankyaha samsarayipi. So the next verse is, samsara anavatarasyat manavaifalyamevacha. Samsara anavatarasyat. There should be no samsara at all. If atma is self-effulgent, self-revealing, there cannot be ignorance about the atma. Therefore, there will be no samsara at all. Samsara anavatarasyat. Avatara means manifestation, avatara. There will be no manifestation of samsara at all. Manavaifalyamevacha. And Shastra, which is, with the purpose of Shastra is what? To reveal the Atma, then also would have no purpose to serve at all, because Atma does not require to be revealed by Pramana. This is Atma is self-effulgent, doesn't require some other awareness, other means of knowledge to reveal it. And therefore, Manavaifalyam, there will be redundance of the Manava the Shruti. Iti Ashankyat, so it is said, Samsaranavatarasyat Manavaifalyamevacha. Iti etasya iha chodyasya pariharaya cha uttaram. It in this manner, etasya iha chodyasya, this chodya meaning this question that arise, pariharaya, for dispelling, for removing these questions or dispelling these questions or answering them, uttaram. So the next passage also is in the form of uttara to these questions. यथा इत्यादि उत्तरत्वेन आदत्ते इति. So यथा हवै पदेन अनुविन्देदेवम, that passage is उत्तर
or answer to all these questions that arise. It's etascheti. So the Tika goes to page 240. Purvoktasya sopaskaram anuditasya chodyasya atkira pariharaya anantaravakyamityardha. All of these questions have been said earlier along with the various reasonings. So these questions are just reiterated here. While discussing that passage, these questions would have been discussed. But here again they are brought up to show that this passage is an answer to those questions. So anantaravakyamityardha tasya uktarthena vakshyamanarthasya samuchyartha chakarah. So chakara is uktarthatvena. So pariharaya cha uttaram. And therefore, that these questions were raised and now those questions are answered by the passage. So that's what samuchya is done by chakara. Okay, continuing the tika on the page 240. Now you'll have a hard time going from one page back and forth. Okay. Pariharam sputaitum vakyam vyachaste. So now pariharam sputaitum, in order to clarify this parihara. Parihara means answering or refuting. So, answering or refuting this question that you have, sputaitum, in order to clear that, vakyam vyachaste, the vakya is the yathahavai padenanuvinde devam, that vakya, that passage, vyachaste, is explained now. So says the verse, yatha gavatmana sakshat gamvinde gopadanugah. Yathahavai padenanuvinde devam, that passage explained by the Vasikara in this verse. Yatha gavatmana sakshat gamvinde gopadanugah. Yatha just as gavatmana sakshat gamvinde gopadanugah. Gopada anugah. The one who follows the footprints of a cow. Sakshat gavatmana gamvinde. So one who is following the footprints of the cow. Vinde, now with vind in the sense of love, labhe, so with labhe. So when the vid dhatu is in the sixth conjugation, then it is in the meaning of labha, to attain. So how gopadanugaha, one who is following the footprints of tracing the footprints of the cow, sakshat gam vinde, how that person gavatmana, how that person attains, requires or obtains that cow as a cow by following the footprints, that's the illustration. That's why illustration is given by Shruti. Yatha havai padenanu vinde, that illustration, evam, that's all, that is dastanta. So only dastanta is explained by Shruti, dastanta is left to us to understand. What does it dastanta, what does it do? Of course, Tadaidat padaniyam asya sarvasya yadayam atma anena hyedat sarvam veda, by as atma one knows everything, yathahavai padenanuvinde devam, just as one knows the cow by the footprints, so also by the atma one knows everything. So anena hyedat sarvam veda, anena atmana edat sarvam, so anatma jatam samastam veda janadi. So earlier to explain how one knows this entire creation and whatever there is to be known by the knowledge of Atma, or is Atma. Or Atmana, of course, by Atma, then Atma should be taken as an instrumental case. So, through the knowledge of Atma, Atmana, through the knowledge of Atma, one knows everything, meaning one knows Brahman. This is what that passage can be understood as. So, yatha, anena, hi etat sarvam veda. Anena atmana he is prasiddhi. Edat sarvam samastam anatma jatam veda janati. So by the atma, meaning by the knowledge of atma, one knows all of this, one knows Brahman. So here Vatikakara wants to explain, how by the knowledge of atma can one come to know Brahman? So therefore, how can one, that is why the Shruti says, yathahavai padenanuvindet evam anena etat sarvam veda. Just as one knows the cow by the footprints, similarly also one knows Brahman by Atma. You see? Just as one knows the cow by the knowledge, by knowing the footprints, so also one knows Brahman by knowing Atma. That's how now the explanation is given. Very brilliant. So very brilliant way of explaining this.
how the ideas come in their mind, you know, but so the Vedanta Siddhanta is there. But to see that Siddhanta in all these simple, innocent looking statements of Upanishad is just amazing. Who can ever figure out this thing when you read this passage? There is no way that even one person of the ideas will occur to us, you know. You think some kind of story is being told, what is it? He entered this and so forth and so on. But from this to derive all these truths of life, from these statements of the Rishis, to look, see in them these truths of life must require a mind that is at least as good as that of the Rishi, I guess, you know. But it's so therefore Vartikakara says that this Vakya, it tells us how one can know Brahman by knowledge of Atma. So yatha gavatmana sakshat gamende gopadanugaha. Just as the one who is tracing the footsteps of the cow comes to know the cow as cow, pratyak chaitanya srutya evam vinde tat paramam padam. Evam means what? Evam the shruti. Yatha havai padenanu vinde evam. Evam means what? The second line says. Pratyak chaitanya srutya evam. Evam means what? Evam in this manner. Pratyak chaitanya srutya. Sruti also means gati. So you follow the footprints of the cow to arrive at the cow. You follow the Atma to arrive at Brahman. So, pratyak chaitanya srutya. But sruti means the passage, the path. So, pratyak chaitanya srutya evam vinde tat paramam padam. So, this etat sarvam means all of this means Brahman. That's how. And so, one knows by knowing oneself, one knows the whole world, whole universe. Meaning one knows Brahman, one knows the essence of the universe. By knowing oneself, one also knows the essence of the universe, that is Brahman. And that's how. Ekena mrutpindena saram mrunmayam vijnatam syat. So knowing one mrutpinda, meaning knowing one Atma, everything becomes known because the Atma that is self is the self of everything. So that is how Vartikara explains how, by knowing the Atma, one knows Brahman. Pratyak chaitanya sutyevam. So by the Shruti, by the path of pratyak chaitanya, vinde tat paramam padam vinde, one obtains or attains that paramapada. So Tika now explains, yatha iti, gavadi kurankitam desham drishtva, tat anurodhena gataha gam anvishyamanah, तद्रूपेण अध्यक्षतः लभते तथा प्रत्येक चैतन्यस्य त्वमर्थस्य श्रुत्या शोधनया तद्रूपेण मुमुक्षु ब्रह्म जानाति इत्यर्थः यथा गवादि खुरांकितं देशं दृष्ट्वा जस्ट एज बाय सीइंग दिस होल एरिया विच कैरीज द इंप्रेशंस ऑफ द फुटप्रिंट्स ऑफ द काउ सो गवादि not confined only cow, any animal, but cow. Tat anurodhena gataha. So one who goes, tat anurodhena, one who follows those footprints. Gam anvishyamanaha. Who is the one who goes there? One who is desirous of searching for the cow, not anybody else. So we may be also walking on that path. But we won't bother about the footprints because we are not interested in obtaining the cow. So one who is interested in obtaining the cow is able to find the cow. So that desire to obtain the cow is very important there. It is not that the footprints necessarily lead us to cow. They do not lead us to cow if we are not interested in the cow. So one who is interested in obtaining the cow obtains the cow by following the footprints. So gam and vishyamana, clarity and precision. What is important is precision. Because by this precision of the example, that also shows the tremendous devotion for Shruti. Who will bother about this much for this passage, you know? But when you dwell upon that with all your devotion, then you can see what all is contained in that simple illustration. And you will get a very important lesson about the life. That's how wherever Acharya looks, everywhere he sees only Vedanta. You know, he sees moon or sun or anything he sees, he finds only Vedanta because to him everything gives a lesson of life. Wherever Dattatreya goes, everybody is his guru.
Everybody seems to reveal to him the truth of life in some way or the other. And so also every sentence reveals so much to them because that perception is there. So, Gam Anvishyamanaha, one who is desirous of searching for the cow. Tat Padanu Gataha, Satad Anurudhena Gataha, one who is following that footprints finds the cow. Adhyakshataha Labhate, Pratyakshataha Labhate, find that cow in the person. So find that cow in the person as cow. That's the explanation of the first line of the verse. Yatha Gavatmana Vinde. As Gavatmana, as a cow, he obtains a cow. Not as some imagination or something. Tatha in the same manner, Pratyak Chaitanyasya Tvamarthasya Srutya. Srutya means what? Shodhanaya. So Sruti, Sruti is what? The Gati. So you follow the path of the Atma. Vakyotta buddhivritya dvaitavasthayameva dvaitabodhena akhandakaram parampadam janatityartha. That by the investigation or deliberation upon the nature of Atma, tadrupena mumukshu brahma janadi. Mumukshu is important. So gam anvishyamanaha, the one who is desirous of searching the cow, he is a mumukshu, one who is desirous of moksha, one is desirous of knowing Brahman, that one discovers Brahman through the knowledge of the self. So, tvam arthasya srutya shodhanaya, by shodhanam meaning by inquiry of tvam artha or atma. Tad rupena, so anena, anena means what? Atmana means what? Atma rupena etat sarvam janati. That's what it was said. So, ittham bhuta lakshana trutiya. So, tad rupena, as atma he knows Brahman. So, tad rupena mumukshuhu brahma janati. Thus, mumukshu knows Brahman as the very self. So, knowledge of little Sanskrit also becomes so useful. Little bit of Sanskrit also, when you know what these vibhaktis are and what their usages are and what the basic meaning of these pratyayas are there, these suffixes and prefixes are there, and what are the basic formations, even that much bit is known, so it makes so much difference in understanding at least what they are saying. That ourselves we may not understand Upanishad or in Bhashya or in Tika, but when all the explanations of Tika are given, at least you can go back and understand. Okay, so this passage is presented as an answer to the question as to how to know Brahma. Then the next verse is, so tvamartham divichya aha. Now what is this tvamartham? Alright, so when you say that by knowing tvam or atma, as Atma one knows Brahman, what is the Atma? Now, the Vatikara takes the occasion to talk about Atma also. Because Atmetyopasita. So one should know the self as Atma. What's the nature of Atma? How should one know the self? So says, Pratyaktaya yadabhati hyagamapai sakshitaha dehendriya manodhishu chaitanya bhasa rupakam. Yet pratyaktaya avadi, that which shines reveals itself as pratyaktaya, as the very self, as the indwelling self. He that shows the prasiddhi, I guess, agama apai sakshitaha. So that which shines is the very sakshi of agama apai. Agama that which comes, apai that goes. So the one that shines as the very self, as a sakshi of the witness of all that is coming and going. The thoughts are coming and going. The events are coming and going. And therefore, all that is coming and going, all that is changing, the one that shines as the very self, as the witness of all that is anatma, all that is coming and going, all that is changing. What are those things that are changing? Deha indriya mano dhishu. Deha indriya manaha dhi. The body, the sense organs, the mind, the intellect, all of the agama pai, coming and going, constantly changing. Chaitanya bhasa rupakam, it gets reflected. So that which gets reflected in deha indriya manodhi, so chaitanya or the atma gets reflected, otherwise you will never know it. You never suspect that there is atma, had atma not been reflected in the buddhi, that's a grace. that Atma gets reflected in the buddhi as ahankara, or Atma gets reflected in the body as the very life. That is how the question of what is the secret of life will arise. You will want to know what is the secret of life when there is life to begin with. And when is life possible? Life is possible only when deha chetanatamaga. Tadahankaramashritya dehas chetanatamaga. The deha becomes chetana. The body is what? Essential or alive, because Atma is reflected there. The sense organs are all functioning because Atma is reflected. The mind and intellect are all functioning because Atma is reflected. So Chaitanya Bhasa Rupakam. So that which shines in Dehendriya Manodhi as Abhasa, as reflected consciousness. So that becomes really the gate, the door to know the Chaitanyam that shines in its own light. As what? As a very Sakshi. All the Dehendriya Manodhi, all of these are changing. So that which shines the very self as a sakshi of all these changing entities, and that also further gets reflected in these entities to enliven them. That is the nature of Atma. Says the Tika, Dehadishu Bahyeshu Agamapayavatsu Yat Pratyakvena Tat Sakshitvena Cha Anvayat Vidarekabhyam Bhadi Tad Edat Padamidhi Sambandha. Atma is Pada. Yasa padedana vindet, Atma becomes pada by which you know Brahman. Tvam pada and tat pada. See, the pada comes there also. The other meaning of the word pada. And the meaning of the word pada is what? Tvam pada. So anena edat sarvam veda. Anena means what? Tvam padena. Edat means what? Tat padam veda. So by tvam pada, one comes to know tat pada. That's another meaning of the word pada. That's the third explanation here, no? So word or footprint or pada means Tvam pada, that word Tvam. So Tvam arthasya, that is how it was said. Yeah. So dehadishu, bhakyeshu, agama. So every time you talk about them, you realize what all is being said, you know. It is not that I know everything before I come here. Swamiji, but when you are saying this, this is not, you know, it is being said. The point is, lots of thoughts occur only as we are talking about it. So as we are just exploring, this is nothing but a joint exploration, that's what it is. And therefore, as this is being explored automatically, a lot of these kinds, then you realize that this is what is being said there. So when you are reading, a lot of these things, you just, you know, you quickly go through them. But even Tikakara, that was so precise, that when he says, that is the, so that is how Padam iti sambandha, then you realize that Tvam Pada is talking about, you see. And how therefore the word pada is understood here as Tvam Pada. How Tvam Pada? Anena hi etas saram veda Tvam Padena. Meaning what? As Tvam Pada. One knows etas saram, meaning Brahman. Because saram hi etas Brahman, that's what Mundaka Upanishad says, I am Atma Brahman. All of this is indeed Brahman. When Brahman is known, all of this is known. And when is Brahman known? Brahman is known when it is known as the very self. So says, I am Atma Brahma. Dehadishu, bahyeshu, agamapayavatsu. This deha, indriya, manaha, dhihi, all of these are bahyeshu, meaning they are all the edatsara of anatma jata. We want agamapayavatsu. They are constantly changing the nature of coming and going. That is all satisaptami. All of these are there at that time. Satisaptami. Yat pratyaktvena abhati, tat sakshitvena abhati. So when all of these are coming and going at that time, when one that shines as pratyaktvena, as the very self, sakshitvena, as a witness also. So it is not pratyaktvena is equal to sakshitvena. Tat pratyaktvena, yat pratyaktvena, tat sakshitvena cha. Anvaya vidireka abhyam bhati. By anvaya vidireka. What is Anvaya? That is all seen, you know, in Anvaya Vidrika, we know now. Sakshi, Sakshya. Karana, Karya. Vyavrutta, Anuvrutta. And Paravananda, Dukhitva. Anyway, all is Anvaya Vidrika Abhyam. So by different ways, Anvaya Vidrika, by the method of agreement and disagreement, meaning when the world shines, the self shines, and the world does not shine, then also the self shines.
The waking and dream state, the world shines, then also I shine. The deep sleep state, the world does not shine, then also I shine. Only when I shine, the world shines. Even when the world does not shine, I shine. This is how Anvaya Vidareka, to determine what is self-effulgent and what is not. So what is permanent, what is impermanent? How do we know? When the body, mind, intellect are impermanent, when they are shining in the waking and dream state, then also I shine. And when they do not shine in deep sleep state, then also I shine. By the Anvaya Vidareka, we realize that Atma is what? The abiding reality. All of these are the changing realities, and in and through the changing realities, one that is the abiding reality. Yat pratyaktvena tat sakshitvena cha Anvaya Vidareka abhyam bhati tat etat padam iti sambandha. So that which shines like this is this pada. Is that pada meaning Atma, that pada by which one knows Brahma. Sakshitve chidabhasasya dvaratvat dyotanartham vishanasti. So for knowing the sakshi, the chidabhasa becomes dvara. So it serves the purpose. That very ahankara which becomes a tremendous nuisance is also the ahankara that becomes a very gate for knowledge. Whether Atma Krupa is there or not, that's all. When Atma Krupa is not there, that very ahankara becomes the greatest of the enemy. When Atma Krupa is there, that very ahankara leads me to the knowledge of the Self. So becomes anukulam. So you'd know, Rama Duhare, Tuma Rakhware. So he's protecting the Atma, you know. So if you have the Krupa of him, so if you have the Krupa of Hanumanji, then Rama is known. So the ahankara is all the time guarding this Atma, the true nature of the Atma. If you don't have his favor, then you are crushed. If you have the favor, then he actually opens the secrets for you, and then the ahankara will drop. Ahankara will not stand in the way only when it becomes anukula. Otherwise, he himself will stand in the way. So ahamayam kuto bhavati chinmata ai patatyaham nija vicharanam, that aham patati when ahankara is anukula. Today you keep on struggling and that ahankara is right in the way. But there was a lot of preparation is required before ai aham patati. That ahankara does not drop because you manipulate the ahankara. So everybody wants to do meditation and manipulate something in many ways so that some vritti arises and stuff like that. You can't manipulate Atma. This is not a manipulation. And something to accomplish in some meditation session that you did something and now. No. Ahankara has to become favorable, as we say. Then alone it will reveal, otherwise it won't. So Prakriti, whatever it is, everything can become a source of great favor. The same Prakriti, when it's not favorable to us, that's why they say, also worshipping Devi. What does it say? That when you are not favorable, then you know how this Mahishasura and all his army is completely destroyed when she is not favorable. But when she is favorable, everything comes. So to make things favorable is so important in life. I think this simple lesson must be learned by us. We cannot bypass all these things and think that Atma, Swamiji, I want knowledge, that's all. Because I want to run away from this life. But unfortunately, you cannot escape anything. We have to settle account with everything, just everything, before Atma can be known as it is to be known. And so it is not by running away. Therefore, this Prakriti must become favorable. That is why they always say, Rama and Sita is Prakriti and Rama is Param Brahma, and how that Jayanta, you know, he came and he, what is it? He did something with Sita. As a crow, yeah. Packing. And one arrow went, you know, and that's all. In all the three worlds that followed, no response, no refuge. Alva came and dropped exhausted in front of Sita. But when he got dropped exhausted, meaning he surrendered to her, then she just turned him, you know, turned him from herself to him, to Rama. That's what she did. So that is why that favor is required. World is this Maya, and it is necessary to get favor of Maya, not by fighting with Maya that you can ever transcend or cross Maya. Never.
by fighting that you can ever cross that. Always by, you by joining. If you cannot win them, join them. That's what they say. Endeavor, you join them. Make them favorable. That is all is called Saguna Brahma, Bhakti, nothing else. What we call Bhakti or devotion of Saguna Brahma is nothing but gaining the favor of Brahman that is manifest as his names and forms. Gaining his favor. Worshipping him, gaining his favor, making him conducive to me, then opens the door for me to know that which transcends the name and form. But name and form first are our friends. Like that old pole is first my friend to lift me up to the 12 feet, and then I can drop it and I can transcend that pole first of all when it has been useful or when it has been made favorable. So this is how all we are saying is that it is necessary, proper way of leading life, and as we said, not only settling accounts but gaining favor. So establishing what we call a favorable, pleasant, not only pleasant, but even the relationship of love with the whole life is so necessary. That's why bhakti comes before it is possible for one to transcend that. Because if that comes right, then, you know, it comes in the way. It won't let you pass. And so it will not let you pass. You know, so that both the things are there. Anyway, I don't know what relation it has with all these things, but the thing is, so Chidabhasasya Dvaratva Dyodhanatam. Chidabhasa becomes Dvara, you know? And so Pratibodha Viditam Matam, how every thought becomes a Dvara. When every thought becomes a Dvara or a means of knowledge of Atma, because every thought reflects consciousness. When the thought has become favorable. When I'm not fighting with that thought, when I'm fighting with my own thoughts, when I'm not comfortable with my own thoughts, I cannot become a sakshi. People have all these notions. Swami, I always remain a sakshi. Sakshi of what? You can be sakshi only when that thing allows you to become a sakshi. It drags you. The thought will drag you before you can even stop and look at it. So when can you become sakshi of the thought? So instead of wasting time in all these unnecessary meditations, if we work, as I say, in living our life properly and all of these, it will be much helpful. There is nothing wrong in meditation, but as I say, let everything become meditation. Pratibodha viditam matam, when that thought can become the object, a means of knowledge, becomes dvara, that's what Shankaracharya explained, that every thought becomes a gate of knowledge of the Atma. By revealing the fact that it reflects Atma, it is bathing in the light of awareness that Atma is, and that's how a thought becomes the gate for knowledge of Atma. Provided I have no ragadvesha with the thought, then alone I can be a witness of the thought without being affected by the thought. Udasina vadasinam. One who is udasinaha, ut urdhvam asinaha. One who doesn't get affected by that, one who is not perturbed. Prakasham cha, pravrittim cha, mohameva cha pandava, na dveshti sampravrittani, na nivrittani kaṅkṣate. So when whatever kind of thoughts come, whether sattvic, rajas or tamas, na dveshti, when it comes, there is no dvesham. Na nivrittani kaṅkṣate, when it goes, doesn't have akāṅkṣa, meaning at home with every thought. When can I be at home with every thought? When I am at home with the object of the thought. And what is the object of the thought? This world. So unless that at homeness, and how do I get the homeness? Only when I invoke the grace. Of what? Of God, who is in the form of this creation. When I secure His grace, then I can be at home with Him. And then that very thing becomes a means, the very duality becomes a means of non-dual. When the duality becomes favorable. So we find a lot of contradictions. Swamiji, when I am Brahman, how can I worship Brahman? I said, worship is to make that very duality favorable. And then it drops. When it doesn't remain there, then as I said, the duality reveals itself to be nothing but non-dual. Same, one Chaitanya alone. So Chidabhasasya Dvaratva is a great favor that Atma has entered here, you know. Saisha iha pravishtaha anakagrebhya. That is entered in this body, right to the toe. You know, we want the tip of the nail. And therefore the body is alive. So there is a question as to who am I? As Aitareya Upanishad says, you know, that the whole thing is ready, but without me, what's the use of that? And therefore, he entered. So that someday people will ask, who am I? So how Chidabhas or Ahankara also becomes a door for the knowledge of the Sakshi. So Chidabhasa, Chitaitanyabhasa Rupakam. Sakshi Availakshanye Katham Sakshitvam. How can Atma be Sakshi or witness? Unless he is Vilakshana, unless he is quite different from what is witnessed. So witness is one that is different from what is witnessed. But if Atma also is one of those things, a similar one of those things of the world, how can that become the witness of the world? For example, this house is built of all the columns and you know, and beams and so forth. That house serves the purpose of someone who is different from beams and columns. That alone cannot indwell of the house, different from the house. And similarly also, if Atma also was one of those things, Atma could not be Sakshi. So Atma is someone who is Sakshya Vilakshana. One is different or distinct from Sakshya, that which is witnessed. Sakshya Availakshanye Kasam Sakshitvam. Unless Atma is Vilakshana, altogether distinct from Sakshyam, what is witnessed, how can he be Sakshi? Tasatatraha. Jadeshu. So the next verse says, Jadeshvekamanekeshu Kutastham Kshanabhangishu Anatmasu Tathachatma Samhateshvapisamhataha. Jadeshu Ajadamityadhyahara Jadeshu Ajadam Ajadam. All the Sakshi, all the Anatma is Jada, all inert. Atma is Ajada, meaning it is conscious. Ekam Anekeshu Tathavi Bhinnatve Dehadivat Asakshitvamiti Asankyaha. Tathavi Bhinnatve Dehadivat Asakshitvamiti Asankyaha. Alright. Suppose it is one among the many and different from them, then also he cannot be Sakshi. Sakshi must be all pervasive. Sakshi cannot be there and he can be Sakshi of something that is totally different from that. So Ekam Anekeshu. That which is one among the many. One among the many. Sakriyatvena asakshitma asankyaha. But how can Atma be Sakshi if he is changing or sakriya, subject to modification or change? Says kutastham kshanabhangishu. So that which is kshanabhangi, all the time, changing every moment. Kshanabhangi what? Getting destroyed every moment. Kutastham, that is changeless in things that are getting destroyed every moment. Pratyaktaya yadabhadi duktam pratyaktvam vinakti. How does it shine in the very self? As the indwelling self. Says anatmasu tathacha atma. So anatmasu tathacha atma. Tatha, in the same manner, he shines as atma as the very self. Atma means the indwelling self among the anatma, among the non-self. Savayatva dehadivat apratyaktvam iti asankyaha. But there also, if Atma is a composite entity consisting of parts, then also Dehadivat apratyaktvam, then it cannot be Pratyakatma, it cannot be the self. So it says, Samhateshu api asamhataha. So one is asamhataha, one who is not composite, not a part of this composite entity. One who is not a part of this assemblage of the body, mind, intellect. One who is not a part of the assemblage. One is still in and through the assemblage. Without being a part of the assemblage, in and through the assemblage. Different from the assemblage and not apart from the assemblage. Then alone he can be Sakshi, otherwise he cannot be Sakshi. Okay, we'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah
ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरि ओम। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम।
वदं रूपयते स एष इह प्रविष्ट आनखाग्रेभ्यः साक्षुरक्षुरधाने वै तस्या विश्वंभरो वा विश्वंभरकुलाय तन्न पश्यन्ति न कृत्स्नो हि सः प्राणन्नेव प्राणो नाम भवति वदन्वा पश्यंश्चक्षुः शृण्वन् श्रोत्रम् मन्वानो मनः तान्यस्यैतानि कर्मनामान्येव स योत एकैकमुपास्तेन स वेद न कृत्स्नो ह्येषः अत एकैकेन भवति आत्मेत्येवोपासीत अत्र ह्येते सर्व एकं भवन्ति तदेतत्पदनीयमस्य सर्वस्येदयमात्मा अनेन ह्येतत्सर्वं वेद यथाह वै पदेनानुविन्दे देवम् कीर्तिं श्लोकं विन्दते एवं वेद। वै पदेनानुविन्दे देवम्। So just as one traces an animal through the pada, where the pada can mean, so one knows an animal such as a cow through pada, namely the word cow. Or one knows an animal such as cow through the footprints by tracing this animal through the footprints. The third meaning of the word pada is being explained, how atma anena shedat saram veda. Anena atma, atmana hi etat sarvam veda. It is as this atma that everyone, that one knows everything. It is as atma that one knows Brahma. And this is what is being explained. Yatha gavatmana sakshat gamvinde gopadanugaha pratyek chaitanya srityevam vinde tat paramam padam. Yatha gavatmana sakshat gamvinde, just as gopadanugaha, one who follows the footprints of a cow, for example, and the one who is desirous of, one is desirous of finding the cow, and one who traces the footsteps of the cow, how the footsteps lead him to the obtaining of the cow. So that's how the pada, the footsteps, become the means of attainment of the cow. Pratyek chaitanya srutya evam vinde tat paramam padam. And similarly also, pratyek chaitanya srutya. Srutya means shodhanaya. By investigating or inquiring into the true nature of pratyek chaitanya, the chaitanya that is indwelling self, vinde tat paramam padam. So one attains that paramam padam, meaning param brahma. How is it so? Pratyektaya yadabhati khyagamapai sakshitah dehendriya manodeshu chaitanya bhasa rupakam. So yat pratyektaya abhati, that which shines as pratyektaya, as that indwelling self, my very self, agama pai sakshitah, as a sakshar witness of agama pai, the deha, indriya, manaha, buddhi, what we call the personality of the prakriti, is agama pai, constantly changing, sakshitah. So one abhati shines as a pratyekatma, as the indwelling self, as well as the sakshi, the witness of all these changing personal aspects of personality. Dehendriya manodheshu chaitanya bhasa rupakam. And that which gets reflected in Deha Indriya, so Deha Indriya Manodishu, Agama Paishu. So every Deha Indriya Mano Buddhi, etc., changing or one gets reflected as the very the one who gets reflected in his upadhi consisting of Deha Indriya Manahadi. That's how does it get reflected? Chaitanya Abhasa Rupakam. As Chaitanya Abhasa. So Bhati, Abhati and Abhasati. He shines in his own way. So it's Tameva Bhantam Anubhadi Sarvam. He shines, that shines and everything shines after. So that is conscious. And the body also is conscious. The sense organs are also conscious. The mind also is conscious. The intellect also is conscious. This personality is conscious. So this personality derives its consciousness from whom? That is the Pratyak Chaitanya. Or the one that shines as a reflected consciousness in this personality. And so as we discussed yesterday, how Chaitanya Abhasa, or the reflected consciousness become the dwar or the gate for knowing the true nature of the self, or leading to the knowledge of the self. Then the next verse is being explained, Sakshya Vailakshanye Kasam Sakshitvam. So this Tvam Artha is being explained here. Tvam Artha means what's the nature of Tvam or the Atma. That is being explained in this verses to show how Atma known in this manner becomes the leads to the knowledge of Brahma. Jadeshu Ajadam Anekeshu Ekam Shanabhangishu Kutastham Anatmasu Cha Atma Samhateshu Abhi Asamhataha. So Jadeshu, what is Sakshyam? What is witness is Jada, is inert. Ajadam, the one that is Ajadam, the one conscious with reference to all those things that are witnessed which are inert. In short, Sakshyam or what is witness is Jada, is Paraprakasham, not self-evident. And this one is Chetanam, meaning Ajadam, self-evident. So that which is self-evident in and through everything that is inert. तथा विभिन्नत्वे देहादिवत् असाक्षित्वम् इति आशंक्य एकम् अनेकेषु. Also the one that is one in and through the many, not that it is separate from the many, as an ordinary witness may stand apart from others, but here one among the many. सक्रियत्वेन असाक्षित्वम् आशंक्याः. But sakshi must be necessarily one that is changeless. So says kutastham kshanabhangishu. Kshanabhangishu, in all of these, dehendriya, manobuddhi, etc., which are kshanabhangi, constantly changing, kutastham, that which is changeless. Pratyaktayayadabhati iti uktam pratyaktvam yanakti. And in what manner do you say that he shines in the very self? Anatmasu tasacha atma. Tasacha, and similarly also, anatmasu, among the non-self, one who is the very self, atma. Sāyavatvād dehādivat apratyaktvam āśaṅkyāha samhateshu. Also if ātmā were a composite entity like the body. So body is that which is made up of many parts. And that which is made up of many parts or components cannot be sākṣi. Because sāvayavam, sāvayavam means that's the composite entity. And that which is composite is made up of very parts. The point is, that which is made up of many parts is necessarily an assembly. An assembly is that which serves the purpose of someone else. An assembly such as a house is that which is made of many components, all of them are jada or inert. And all of that is assembled for the sake of someone who is a conscious being. So body is an assembly consisting of many parts such as hands and legs and whatever. Therefore we infer that the body as an assembly must be put together by someone who is other than the body and a conscious being, and for the sake of someone other than the body, the conscious being. So thus the rule about an assembly or assemblage is that it must be put together by someone other than the one who is not part of the assemblage, and it is assembled for the purpose of someone who is not part of the assembly, and that someone must be a conscious being. If Atma also were a composite entity made up of various components, Savayavam, then we would imagine that those components must have been put together by someone other than those components, in which case Atma also would serve the purpose of someone else. So it is said here that Niravayavam Asamhateshu Samhateshu Asamhatah. So among those which are assembled, the one who is not part of the assembly. Now continuing, the Tika says on the page 240, somewhere in the middle, Shodhitam Tvamasamuktva Tasya Brahmaikyam Pratipadattvam Pratijanite. Shodhitam Tvamasamuktva Sis Pratyak Chaitanya Srutya. So Pratyak Chaitanya Shodhanaya, by inquiring into the true nature of what is the meaning of Tvam or Pratyak Chaitanya. So these two verses told us, describe what is the nature of the Self. And so, tasya brahmaikyam pratipadattvam pratijanite. It is this Self that is now known as ekam anekeshu, ajadam jadeshu, asamhatah samhateshu. And thus the one who is known in this manner as one, as non-dual, as changeless, as a witness, as a consciousness, as the very Self, as self-evident. So Atma or I, the true meaning of the word I is this. This is called Shodhanam, an inquiring or investigation. So as I take the I today, I take myself as a changing entity, as one among the many, is also subject to modification. And thus it is said that no, all these ideas or notions about I arise on account of taking this upadhi as I. But in fact, I am Sakshi. I am the very witness of this upadhi. And thus, Shodhitam Tvamartham Uktva Tasya Brahmaikyam Prati Padatvam Prati Janite. How this Tvampada or the Atma, who is thus known in its pure way, form, how that becomes the Pada. Now Pada means a step, means a means, becomes a means for unknowing the Brahmaikyam, the identification with Brahma. Pratijanite, that pratijna is being done, promise is being given in the next verse, Tasyeti. So says Vartika, Tasya Vakya Sarupasya Padametat Prachakshade Padyate Nena Tadyatsmat Tenedam Padamuchyate. Tasya Vakyartha Rupasya. Tasya Avakyartha Rupasya Brahmanah. Tasya is the sixth case of Tat. So we are talking of Tat Pada. Tat means Brahma. So Tasya means Brahmanah Avakyartha Rupasya. So remembering again the Nishkarma Siddhi, Brahma is what? Not Vakyartha Rupam. Of course here also the discussion came that Vakya can give you the meaning, or Vakya can create a knowledge which either is characterized by Bheda or Samsarga. Bheda, where two entities are separate from each other but connected. And Abheda, where two entities are separate, alright, but identified, you know. So Rama and cow, these are Rama, Gam, Anaya. So Rama and the cow are the entities that are separate but connected. As Rama is the one who brings and cow is that which is brought. Or Neelamutpalam, the blue lotus, where blue and the lotus are two entities that are not, that are separate alright, but still, they're different alright, but still non-separate. So in short, as we have discussed any number of times, a vakya or a statement can give us the knowledge of an entity that is known by us in association with something. Our mind knows things in association with something or is qualified by something. Whereas Brahman is not associated with anything nor qualified by anything. In that sense, it is said it is avakyam. So avakyartham So Brahman is revealed by the Vakya Tattvamasi. But then the meaning is not a conventional meaning that there is Veda or Samsarga. This is what we call Akhandartha, where Tat and Tvam are not related to each other or not connected in a non-separate way, but then they are identical in primary way. So avakyartha rupasya padam edat prachakshate. Says the Tika, brahmanah tadarthasya akhandasya. So akhanda is that where that relationship which is devoid of or free from any relationship or relation or qualification and qualifier, one that is free from any kind of a qualification or relationship, that is called akhanda. So between tat and tvam there is no relationship, nor there is even a relation, you know, the connection or relationship of the qualification and the qualifier. Brahmanah tadarthasya akhandasya. So thus Brahman, which is the meaning of the word tat, which is akhandam, pratyaktvena shodhitam, pratyak chaitanyam hetu ityartha. So padam etat pratyakshate. Etat means what? Pratyaktvena shodhitam pratyak chaitanyam. So thus pratyak chaitanya, that is thus understood as pratyaktvena shodhitam pratyak chaitanyam. Pratyak chaitanyam, that is known as pratyak atma, the very self. So that pratyak chaitanya, or the indwelling consciousness, which is understood, which is known as self, becomes padam. It becomes hetuhu ityartha. It becomes hetuhu, the very cause or the means of leading to the knowledge of identity with Brahman. Kasam tvamartha tadarthasya padamiti asankhya karna vitpatya ityaha. How can it be that tvamartha, so that which is the meaning of the word tvam, namely atma, tadarthasya padam, how can atma become the padam or the hetu or the means for knowing tat or brahma? Karana vitpatya, the word pada can be explained, karana vitpatya padyate anena iti padam, or karma vitpatya padyate iti padam. So this was in the Mandukya Upanishad, but anyway, here padam is padyate anena. So it was said, soyamatma chatushpat. This atma is chatushpat. Atma is four pada. Jagrat, swapna, susupti, turiyam. Where jagrat, swapna, susupti are called pada in the sense of padyate anena. They lead to the knowledge of that pada turiya, which is padyate iti padam. So chatushpat, atma has four pada or four pada. But then the meaning of the word pada is different for the first three and different for the fourth. Here atma becomes padam in the sense of the means padyate anena. Say the tika shodhitena hi tvamarthena tadarthaha swarupadaya jnayate. So when you thus inquire into, when you truly understand the nature of tvam, tadarthaha swarupadaya jnayate, then that tvam is recognized to be none other than Brahman, and therefore Brahman alone is, Brahman indeed is known as the very self. Thus when the self is inquired into, then it turns out to be Brahman, and therefore Brahman is known as a self. Thus you begin with tvam and discover it to be tat. Again, of course, by the teaching, not that you investigate, because again the question will be, if I am not this, not this, then who am I? Then tat tvamasi, so tvamasi, tat tvamasi, this is what the Shruti would say. Shodhitena hi tvamarthena tadartha swarupataya jnayate padartha jnana adhinatvat vakyartha jnanasya ityartha. As you said, vakya or a sentence can be known only when the words comprising of that sentence are known, and so when tat and tvam are known, then the vakya tattvamasi is known. In short, when tvam is properly known, when atma is properly known, then Brahman also is known as the very self. Now another little discussion is pursued here to bring back the
asatya upaya and satya upaya. So the tika, look at the tika here. Pratyakshitah brahmadi hetoho yathartyavat. So what happens is, the question is raised, a genuine question. You say that pratyak chaitanya or the atma is padam, is a means for knowledge of Brahma. Pratyak chitah brahmadi hetoho yathartyavat. Now pratyak chaitanyam, meaning the indwelling self, that becomes the very means of knowledge of Brahman. So your means is pratyak chaitanyam, the end is Brahma. Brahma is satyam, but pratyak chaitanyam also is satyam. Therefore, the means or upaya, which is pratyak chaitanyam, also is satyam. The upaya Brahman is also satyam, and therefore here the means is also real, and the end also is real. So, tadvat, similarly also, acharya dehevi taddhi hetoho. So similarly also the question is, that shruti acharya, you said earlier, become the hetu or the means for the knowledge of Brahman, then we would say that, even the shruti acharya, this means also, must be yathardam, must be real. So pratyak chaitanyam, which is the means of knowledge of Brahman, is real. So also Shruti and Acharya, if they are the means of knowledge of Pratyak Chaitanya Brahma, they also should be real. Just a question. Nitan mithyatum yuktam, therefore, you cannot say that Shruti, Acharya, etc. are mithya. Otherwise Pratyak Chaitanya is real and the still a means. So Shruti, Acharya also should be real because they are means. And therefore, it's not fair or proper to say that this Shruti, Acharya are mithya. Iti āśaṅkya. Now, all right, let us ask you this question. Āchāryādi svataha anyatova siddhyati iti vikalpya. Let us ask you this question. Āchāryādi, āchāryādi means, this means, śruti, āchārya, this whole śravanam, mananam, all of this, svato siddhyati anyatova. So, do they exist on their own account, or do they exist because of something else? Meaning, do they enjoy their own satta, or their satta is because of something else? Like a pot enjoys its own satta, or its satta is due to something else, namely clay. So that is how we decide whether a given thing is satya or mithya. So we want to look at the nature of thing and decide its reality, rather than going roundabout way that because it is means, therefore it must be real or what it is. Let us look at the nature of Shruti Acharya as they are, and ask this question. What is the criterion for determining the reality of a thing? So understand that reality of something is determined not because it is useful. So usefulness is not the criterion to determine the reality. For example, sometimes some patients are so paranoid that they just get sick because they think that such and such thing has happened, some virus has come to them, and they cannot be recovered unless they get a sudden injection, you know, for example. So these patients come to the doctor and say, I want such and such injection. Why? Lot of energy is there. Alright, doctor gives an injection. Doctor knows very well that this is purely a psychological thing. So doctor gives injection of pure distilled water. And that person just becomes, you know, gets cured. And therefore, so just because the person got cured does not mean that the injection was real. You have to look into the nature of what was administered to determine whether it is real or not. Similarly also here, just because Shruti Acharya have become the means of knowledge of Brahma does not mean that they are real. Let us look at the reality of the prapancha. So Shruti Acharya stands for the whole prapancha ultimately, no? If one thing is proved to be real, then everything of that class is proven to be real. So this is Shruti Acharya, that just becomes little, you know, a representative of the whole creation. And so let us look at that and then determine whether or not they are real. So criterion of reality is not usefulness. Criterion of reality is whether a thing is real only when it exists by itself. It is self-existent. That it does not depend, derive its tattva or existence or something else. If something derives its existence from something else, then we call it unreal.
Therefore we call pot unreal. Even though, and clay is real, look at this. Lump of clay which is not useful at all is called real. And pot which serves such a lot of purpose is unreal. Now this is how it is. So pot is unreal. Why? Because its sattva or existence depends purely on clay. And remove the clay from the pot, there is no such entity as pot. Therefore we say that pot is unreal or mithya. Totally unemotional approach here, you know. An emotional approach to determining the reality of pot is Nayayika says, wait a minute. Satya means artha kriyakaritvam. That which serves the purpose is called real. So they would say that the mirage water is not real because it does not serve the purpose. Whereas the water in your pot is real because it quenches your thirst. So they want to define reality as artha kriyakaritvam satyatvam. Vedantins say, no, no. Reality is not to be determined because of usefulness, because what do you mean by usefulness? Even usefulness also is something very relative. Usefulness of a given thing depends upon time, place and condition. And therefore, all these objects of the waking world, such as water and everything else, they fail to serve their purpose for the same person when he is in dream. Therefore, I am sleeping with a water pot right beside me. So in night also we leave a water pot beside us so that if I feel thirsty at night, I can immediately have water. The water pot is lying just beside me and I am very thirsty, where in dream. And I am thirsty for hours together and I am suffering from the pangs of thirst. And this water that is lying just beside me is of no use at all. So how do you say even this water is useful? That way also usefulness is discarded. And I said, this looks very unemotional approach, you know. No, you can't say that this water is not useful, you know, and things like that. We want to somehow prove its usefulness, and so that you can prove the reality. So this is how, this is what we call, this is called attachment, you know. This is a, you must unattach this, not that you discard it, or not that you hate it or anything like that. Unattached is not that. Just understand it for what it is, that's all. Nothing more than that. And don't impose anything more than that. So attachment is imposing what it doesn't have. And aversion is again imposing what it doesn't have. Anyway, so in short, this question is asked here. Acharyadi svato anyatova siddhyatiti vikalpya. Please tell us whether this prapancha, does it exist on its own accord or does it exist because of something else? Adyam anuvadati. Says, all right. Suppose this Shruti Acharya, which are the means of knowledge of Brahma, if they exist on their own accord, then next verse is, Swamahimnaiva chet siddhet. So there is anuvada of the question. That let us say that the Acharyadi obtain or exist on their own accord. Swamahimna. So whether, if that was a question. So where is Atma, or where does he abide? So Sve Mahimne Tishthade. He abides in his own glory, meaning he abides in his own Satta. So if you say that, Swamahimna Eva Chet Siddhet, if you say that Acharyadi Prapancha, he obtains or exists by his own Mahima, meaning by his own Satta. Upaya Paramarthavat. Then that upaya also will become real. So that's what the says the Tika. Sada svataha siddhe saha chaitanyavat na jadasyade dushayadi paramarthavata. In that case, if it is self-existing, and it should be self-effulgent also. What is self-existing also should be self-evident or self-effulgent. But then we know that this prapancha is not self-effulgent. It only shines when it is illumined by chaitanyam. So svada svataha siddhe sa chaitanyavat na jadasyade dushayati. Then it cannot be, it would be like chaitanya, it cannot be jada if it is sattva siddham. So paramasavata, in that case, it would be self-evident, self-effulgent. Paramarthavat svata siddhe namityatvam tasya syat. Paramarthavat svatasiddhe tasya mithyatvam nasyat. In that case, this acharya would not be mithya, because it would be self-evident also. But inasmuch as they are not self-evident, they are mithya, and therefore, so you cannot say that they are self-existent. Paratasiddhau tasya mithyatvam syat adhyasika sambandhat rute drushatra siddhe. Can you say, for example, can you say that Acharya is unless you see him? See, unless you are aware of this, even Acharya or Shruti or whatever it is, unless, so this is the nature of every object in creation. That object is the existence of an object is established only when an object is known. Otherwise you cannot say that this particular object is unless it is known. And when can it be known? Only when we operate pramana or a valid means of knowledge. So meaning that you open your eyes and see that object, then you can determine that it is there. Or touch it, or do something else. Five organs of perception are there. So smell it or something. But unless there is a contact with the sense organ, unless the sense organ illumines the sense object, there cannot be awareness of the sense object, and therefore sense object cannot be known unless it is illumined by pramanam or a valid means of knowledge. Similarly also, Acharya, Shruti, etc. will not be known unless they are seen by you or heard by you. And so, drute drusha tat asiddhehe. Unless drusha, unless meaning the druk, or unless the seer, the witness is there, there is no way to determine that Acharya, etc. is there. So inasmuch as the existence of Acharya, etc. is established only when they are known, therefore we say that they are jada. What is jada? Paraprakashyam. That is illumined by something else. So all the objects of the world are illumined by Atma. How does the Atma illumine? Atma illumines the mind. The mind illumines the sense organs. And sense organs in turn illumine the objects of the world. And Shruti Acharya, all of them also fall in the category of objects of the world. And therefore, they are also illumined. So, rute drusha tasiddhehe. So, drusha rute, without drusha, without the druk, or without the consciousness, since Acharya, etc. cannot be known, and since their existence cannot be proven unless they are known, see, that is not the case with Atma. You cannot say that Atma is because I see him, or I hear him, or I think of him. There is no need to see, hear, touch, taste, feel, experience, think, anything at all about Atma, because Atma is self-evident, which means that it does not require pramanam or a means of knowledge to illumine that. Whereas all the objects of the world require pramanam, a means of knowledge to illumine them, and therefore they are not svatasiddha, therefore mithyatvam. Svatasiddhena mithyatvam tasya syat paramarthavata. And so they would be paramartha, they would be absolutely real, in which case they should be self-evident. That not being the case, they are jada. Then continuing, kincha upayaha paramarthat abhinno bhinnova na adhyaha ityaha paramarthavadidhi. So again, continuing that verse, paramarthavat is the last word. Paramarthavat, paramasat, abhinnaschet, next verse. Nitaram, amrushatmana, ityadi, puramuktam. Paramarthavat, paramasat, abhinnaschet. All of the standard ways of dealing with a thing, whether it is separate or non-separate. Kinchu upayaha, paramasat, abhinno, bhinnova. This question we always ask about the rope and the snake. To determine the reality of the snake, we ask this question. Does the snake exist in its own right or not? We say no, because snake is because a rope is. And therefore, that which exists on account of something else is mithya. We ask the question, is the snake separate from the rope, or is the snake one with the rope? You cannot say the snake is separate from the rope, because in this case it would be real. Snake is not even identical to rope, because then it would always be there wherever the rope is. So you cannot say the snake is identical to rope, because snake is not there when the rope is known as rope. Nor can you say snake is separate from the rope, because snake does not exist independent of the rope. Therefore you cannot determine really the relationship of snake with the rope, whether it is separate or it is one. And so that which cannot be determined as such and such is mithya. And similarly also, prapancha, is it separate from Brahma or is it one with Brahma? Kincha upaya paramartha abhinna bhinnavana adhyaya idyaha paramarthavada paramarthat abhinnaschet nidaram amushatmana. If it is abhinna, it is not separate from paramartha or atma, then this upaya would be definitely real. Sarupena upaya satvaya satyatve satyatva ishtehe tat abhinnatva upagamacha atishaya tan musartha musartha abhavat vastvantara abhavacha tadadvayamiti bhavaha. In short, sarupena upaya satvaya satyatva ishtehe, if you say that upaya, namely acharya adi prapancha, is real, in which case then tat abhinnatva upagamacha, and also since you consider it to be non-separate from Brahma, then musartha, musartha bhavat, vastvantara bhavat cha tadadvayam, in which case it is not musha, meaning it is not mithya, it is real. And so vastvantara bhavat cha tadadvayam, and there is no separate thing, therefore Brahma becomes advayam or non-dual. And therefore, whatever appears to be dual has to be accepted as mithya. Na dvitiyah bhedasya pramanikatvat. So you cannot say that acharya they are different from Brahma also. Bhedasya pramanikatvat, because bheda, the duality from Brahman, cannot be established, just as a snake cannot be established as separate from the rope. Nacha bhedam kurvatah akurvatascha upayatvam atah sarvasya upayasya dvaya chidatmani kalpitatvam. In short, therefore just as the snake is superimposed upon the rope, we say that all this prapancha is superimposed upon the advitiya atma. Avyakrata vicharada uktam. So all of this has been threshed out earlier in the avyakrata vichara. Tadhitarhi avyakrata masi atra upaya asatyatve hedutvena jnayam. And therefore, whatever was determined, all this was discussed earlier. And so, whatever was talked about as far as the